Hi guys, welcome back to Rara's Adventures. This is my first vlog on visiting a location. Thank you for joining me. This is Rustington Museum and Information Centre. So, at Rustington Museum, it's based behind Waitrose in the car park. There is disabled parking and a drop-off bay there. You can park there for 3 hours and then you're not allowed to return within 2 hours. Even if you've been there for 5-10 minutes, you're still not allowed to return, unfortunately. To enter the museum, you go through automatic doors and you are then placed in the information centre where they have information about local events going on in Rustington and nearby. We also have a stand with leaflets in with tourist information in. They also will enter the museum. The museum door is a manual door. So as you can see, I'm standing here. I am just introducing you and welcoming you to Rustington Museum. And the museum opened on the 31st of October 2019 and it's also funded by the National Lottery Heritage. Yep, they have chairs put out as you can see to the left. If you know you're going with a group of people, you can phone up beforehand and they will put more chairs out for you so that you're able to sit down as you walk around. You can see that it's nice, light, airy, all one level, and lots of stuff for children and adults to interact with. Here you can see I'm showing some of the props, and they've got little boxes for you to open to learn about different things they have found. And underneath they've got props that you can play or dress up with, which is always nice for adults and children. So I'm just going through what they have here. Obviously I don't want to show too much because we want you to go and visit. Here I'm showing you a map of local buildings that are still here, what they were and what they are now, and where they are dotted around Rustington. It's a really light, airy room as you can see. Plenty of room for wheelchairs, buggies to move around in. All lovely and airy. And then we make our way around to the next part. Obviously I'm still waffling on as you can see through the video. And we walk round and they have lots about the history of World War 1 and 2. And the sign there you can see is from the Lamb Pub, which has been reconditioned, and there's a little picture there of what it used to look like and a bit of history about the Lamb Pub sign. I love this sign, it's so sweet, it's really nice. I think there I'm just reading a bit of the history. Obviously I can't remember what that said, I'm terribly sorry, so you'll have to go along and have a little visit. Here is more about the history of who was around, what they did, the years of when they were there, books, all the books on the history of Rustington, again about the war as well, the planes, what they went through, what things were like back then. I think it's amazing. If I had more time I would have stayed there and read probably all of it. It's really my cup of tea personally. Here you can see we're looking at newspaper cuttings, which is really nice. Then you can see there is a plaque from Her Majesty the Queen on the Gazette, the London Gazette, which is really cool to look at. So much information in such a small museum. It's really interesting. I think it's great. Definitely worth a visit. So then we start moving around, and again, there's lots of pictures and lots of stuff to read. I'm just showing you that it's really accessible. There's more seats to sit on in case you need to. Information about the First World War in Rustington, what happened in Rustington, all the old pictures. I love it, absolutely love it. If this is the sort of thing you like, I'd definitely go and visit. So much history here about Rustington Church there. I think that's what I'm showing you. Oh yes, it's time to be silly. I have to try the props on. It's part of what I've got to do, you know. See, don't I look fetching? It's not just for kids, it's for adults too. Obviously that one's plastic. Back in the day it probably would have been metal. I might be wrong. If you know what it was, let me know. Also, they've left a gas mask for you to see what it was like. I do believe I attempt to put this on, but in all seriousness, what would this been like back in World War One, where you'd have to carry this around because you got bombed? How scary is that? Really makes you think. Carrying that around with you every day, just in case. Scary thought, isn't it? I'd love to go back in time, not obviously to be in the war, but to experience what it would have been like back then to what it's like now. Here are some tags that you can write on, and we actually found the reason why, because this propeller has lots of names and signatures on, and you can leave on the tag what you think why they left their names on the propeller, which is nice. It's another little interaction. It makes you think a bit more about what happened when this propeller was being signed, what they're going through. It's just something new to think about, and something interactive as well. Here you can see I'm reading it again. I can't remember what it says, I'm truly sorry, but another good reason to go and visit, definitely. Then we move on, we look at these little dolls. There's some information about it, but they're really sweet. From the picture, it looks like they're used to be played with in dolls' houses. They're so sweet. It's not like today, is it? So then we move over, and there is a listening station where you can listen about the war, Rustington, the planes, what happened, how that it got used, what parts, just all the history of Rustington past. Really good. And if you're dyslexic like me and you struggle reading, this is perfect because I could sit there all day and listen to this. So it's quite thoughtful, I think. Unfortunately, they don't currently have hearing loops. It's quite a new build. I'm not sure if they'll be getting hearing loops. I don't know at this stage. But that's probably the only thing that you do listen to. So it's not too bad. And then behind me is an old cigarette dispenser, which I think is really cool. But as you can see, I've gone over here. As you can see here, you have to smell the box below and then guess what the smell is, and then lift the top of the box and that will explain what it is. As that one says, it's tomatoes. So here we are, you can see that we're going back. It's the cigarette dispenser. I love this, just the fact that it's, you know, really old school. 2 pennies, sixpence, and look at these little boxes, they're so sweet. I love them, really nice. Not like nowadays, obviously, and not that I'm encouraging smoking, of course. But yeah, that tells you all the history again about tobacco, where it was grown, and everything. So yeah, as you can see, I really enjoyed that bit. So yeah, you can see it's not a massive museum, but it holds a lot of information. It's really cool. And down here you've got props and books, and as you can see, I'm trying it on again. Like I said, you've got to do it. Doesn't matter if you're an adult, child, it's got to be done. And it's good fun. Why not? Very fetching hat, don't you think? So, from there, they've got bits like that all around the museum. It's really fun. Oh, look. I like this one. Ta-da! So, yeah. Once I finish being silly, we then move over to the bell. Yep, so this bell we think was used either to raise alert of war, of bombs coming, of fires. I again can't remember the information, I'm truly sorry. But now it's been placed in this box where you can leave donations to help support the museum, as it's all voluntary based and funded. So if you have a spare couple of pennies, place them in, and when you put the penny in, it will make a little ding noise as it hits the bell. It's quite cool, something different. Such a light, airy museum, it's really refreshing. Here is a visitor's book where you can sign when you've been. I think you're meant to start this way because you can pick this passport up and fill out the information as you walk around. So bear that in mind. There's lots of bits to look out for. It's another thing to keep engaging the kids and adults as you're walking around. I think that's a really good idea. And then you've got a visitor's book where you can say if you've enjoyed it, and you put a little card up saying which bit you enjoyed the most. As you walk over to the centre of the room, there is a monitor with table and some stools that are movable, and you can touch on each thing, either the history of the buildings or the Rustington Circle or about the airspeed record. Again, you press it and then you can carry on pressing each individual house to learn about the history of what it was, what it is now, whether it got bombed, whether it didn't get bombed. It's just all really interesting, worth looking at, and seeing what it looked like back in the day to what it looks like now makes you look at it differently, I think. Yep, and as I was saying, these chairs are easily removable. So if you're in a wheelchair, you can just scooch them out of the way so you can sit down or wheel in comfortably to have a look. Okay, so that is our vlog on Rustington Museum. I'm just pointing out the planes, because I do believe when you press the plane, there you go, that will make a noise. So it makes noises too, which is cool. Tells you information, like I was saying. Okay, so yeah, this is Rustington Museum. I really hope that you enjoyed this vlog. And I hope that you come down to have a little visit. Definitely worth it. Free admission. Leave a donation if you can. And it's something fun to do with the kids, get out the rain and interact with each other and learn about the history of Rustington. So thank you very much for watching. I will leave a couple of pictures at the end of this video. And next week we will have a new vlog with a new location. So if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe, like, follow, share. Also, you can find me on Facebook, which I'll also leave the link in, and on my website. So I hope you have a lovely week, and I will see you next Sunday at same time with a new exciting adventure. Thank you for watching. Bye.